Hi, I'm Srija Chatterjee. I'm the MD of Publicis Worldwide. I think the Indian advertising industry is as good as any other industry globally. We came onto the digital scene a little later, but I think we've leapfrogged and we are today as good as anybody else. Our creative, I believe, is far more nuanced and very much which caters to the Indian audience. So sometimes it's difficult for the global guys to sort of understand what we are doing, but our Indian consumers totally get it. So we are clearly more nuanced, localized, and something that we do which resonates deeply with the Indian consumers. But at a fundamental level, I think our industry is at par with anybody internationally. So I think the audience is changing, and what is making the audience change is really the digital world. And there is so much of influx of, you know, the Facebooks and YouTubes, of course, are there. The latest phenomenon to hit our industry is TikTok. So I think it is important that we understand these fundamental different platforms and not do a digital idea which is, you know, we'll go digital. So our understanding is, let's create platform leaders. Each leader has to understand that platform in depth, and we give solutions which are platform oriented rather than just, you know, this seems like an interesting digital idea and therefore what should I take this idea and do in YouTube and do in TikTok. We look at it from a platform perspective and say, this platform, how best can I capitalize on this platform for my brand and the idea I want to showcase. So for us, it is important that we understand this digital landscape. That's point one. The point two is, you know our Publicis communications power of one, which we keep talking about, and we strongly believe in that. We believe that it is important for us to look beyond our usual retainer model from the clients and be true partners to the clients across all their marketing problems, and therefore whether it's digital, whether it's experiential, whether it's entertainment, whether it's content, whether it's film, or whether it's regular advertising or PR, we need to be there everywhere. So power of one is really what we are imbibing more and more, and as we do it more and more, we are becoming more and more specialists in it. So as I said, this is, I mean, the digital arena is what are the trends. Understanding that arena well and giving solutions. So for example, we've worked with a brand where we did a complete TikTok based campaign, and that was only purely for TikTok. So understanding these arenas properly and giving solutions that are bespoke for that platform, I think is very critical. And looking at the client's business not just as a, what is the TVC I'm going to do or what's the video content. I mean, okay, today agencies have moved forward from the TVC to video content and using digital medium and long format video for digital. But beyond that, how else can I engage with the consumer with the mindset of understanding the client's problems and being a little bit more acquisition oriented is where I think the key is. So I think I expect more acts in 2020 and more of the same. I mean, few agencies went in and we did a great job. Next year, I'm sure, seeing the success this year, many more will be going in, and there will be a lot more acts that we will be doing, which will then create this connection with the consumer, which then will be amplified on digital. So getting more into the so-called phygital world, which is, you know, the physical world and the digital world, and doing acts that are around that. We've done that. I think I will see more of that next year. So I think it is, I mean, it's all back to what I said. It is about understanding the client's problems. And we know next year it's the economy is not doing very well. And there will be, I mean, when the economy doesn't do well, there will be pressures on our clients. And when there's pressures on our clients, there are pressures on us. So how do we partner the client during this time of pressure, understand his problems, give business solutions, which have, of course, some communication in it, but they are not only from the lens of, again, what's the, you know, communication solution, but what's the larger business solution that can then help the, you know, client get more out of the economy, so to say. I think partnering the client will be the critical thing. If we can do that well, then I'm sure the clients will be with us and we'll have a fantastic 2020. So the people I look for, I can only talk about when I interview people, what are the things I look for in them. So to me, body language is a big thing. So I mean, it's this whole hunger, passion. I mean, it's oft talked about, but I think that separates the great from the good. So that to me is very critical. I want to learn something. I want to invest in this industry. I don't want to use this industry as a stepping stone to go somewhere else. I want to, you know, understand how communication and entire marketing thing is done, which, I mean, we do a lot more of beyond communication, right? So it's that hunger, passion, willingness to work long hours because that's part of our life. And somewhere I think there needs to be some sort of an entrepreneurial sort of bent of mind, because I think those people go longer. Because when you think that this is your client, your business, you need to do the best for it, rather than I am coming in the morning to work in this agency who's going to give me money on 30th or 31st of the month, then the mentality is completely different. So those kind of people, I think, is something that I look for when I interview people. I think it all boils down to what's the different thing I did to stand out. Because there are, I mean, everybody's good. Many people are good. As I said, to separate the good from the great, there has to be something that made me stand out. What is that stand out? I mean, in the Indian idols of the world, they are called X factor, but I don't think in our industry you can call it X factor, but there is a factor. So what is that factor that made me stand out from the rest, and why therefore I should be the one chosen under 30 with the few 30 people rather than be the 31st or the 32nd? So I'll look for that specific thing.